For diabetics, controlling blood sugar levels may be tricky, but the good news is there's something you can do to get control of your blood sugar levels, and that is changing your diet. What you eat each day has huge effects on blood sugar levels, but it's often confusing when doctors are telling you so many different things and using huge scientific words. Have you ever worried that what you're eating might be raising your blood sugar? Well, you're not alone. It's difficult to know what you're allowed to eat and what's going to cause your blood sugar levels to skyrocket. So don't worry, we're here to simplify it all for you. In this video, we're going to expose our top 7 whole grains for blood sugar control. These foods help to reduce oxidative stress, keep your gut healthy, and help your digestive system. As well as that, we're going to tell you which whole grains help to reduce inflammation and why this is important for blood sugar control. Also, stick around to find out how you can get 2 free gifts. Before we get started, make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. And now it's time to reveal these amazing 7 whole grains. Coming up first, we've got a whole grain which originated in China 6,000 years ago. Let's get started. Number 7, buckwheat. Buckwheat is a very nutritious whole grain. Buckwheat is a pseudo-cereal, meaning it's a plant that produces fruits or seeds that we know as grains. Pseudo-cereals are usually high in protein and often gluten-free. Some people call them ancient grains. Buckwheat is in lots of common food products, such as breakfast foods, flour, and noodles. In fact, it's also used by farmers to feed livestock. Buckwheat is full of some amazing nutrients. It's a fantastic source of protein, fiber, and complex carbs. What exactly are complex carbs, you ask? These are carbs that have longer chains of sugar molecules than simple carbs. These sugar molecules convert into glucose, which your body uses for energy. Because complex carbs have longer chains, they take longer to break down than simple carbs, which means that they give you a longer lasting form of energy. Also, it means they don't raise your blood sugar levels as quickly as some carbs do. Simple carbs are found in foods like candy, fruit juice, and white bread. According to the Journal of Diabetes Research, buckwheat may have a positive effect on your insulin and blood sugar. This is because buckwheat contains a special diabetes-fighting ingredient called D-tyroinositol, or DCI. This is a chemical compound that helps insulin work properly, helping to lower your blood sugar levels. It does this by reducing oxidative stress levels and increasing insulin sensitivity. Try buying buckwheat flour instead of regular flour from your local grocery store. It's gluten-free and it will give your cooking a slightly nutty and smoky flavor. Coming up, we've got another fantastic whole grain which is rich in antioxidants and fiber. Number 6, brown rice. You may think brown and white rice are quite similar, but their nutritional content is actually very different. Brown rice contains bran and germ, which gives many essential vitamins and minerals. Compared to this, white rice is a refined grain. This means it's gone through a process to have those parts removed. This makes white rice softer and cooks quicker, but it also means a lot of the nutrients have been taken out of it. Brown rice is a great source of fiber, antioxidants, and lots of other vitamins and minerals. It's particularly high in the antioxidants flavonoids. These are a plant compound, which helps to reduce the risk of oxidative stress. So, what is oxidative stress? Well, it's an imbalance of free radicals and antioxidants in your body. This can cause damage to your body's cells and tissue. Also, high levels of oxidative stress may cause complications for diabetics. When you have high blood sugar levels, the linings of your blood vessels take in more sugar than they should. This causes oxidative stress and may also cause an excess amount of fat and cholesterol to build up on your artery walls. This is called atherosclerosis, and it's a very serious health condition. Luckily, the antioxidants in brown rice are able to fight against oxidative stress. Also, the flavonoids found in brown rice may help reduce the risk of other chronic illnesses, such as heart disease, cancer, and Alzheimer's disease. Choose brown rice over white rice to help fight against oxidative stress. Up next, we have a whole grain you might not have heard of before, but one you should definitely add to your diet. Number 5, millet. Millets are a group of small-seeded grasses. They're grown around the world as cereal crops or grains for food. Millets are a low glycemic index food, meaning they're diabetes-friendly. Because millets are a low glycemic index food, your body takes longer to break down the carbs in them. This makes your blood sugar levels rise a lot slower than other foods. This slow carb release gives you a slow and sustained release of energy. Foods that have a high glycemic index cause a spike in your blood sugar levels. They do this because they release sugar into your bloodstream at a quicker rate. High glycemic foods are ones like white rice and sugary drinks. According to the Journal of Food and Nutritional Disorders, adding millets to your diet will help to lower your blood sugar levels. The study also found that they're able to reduce both fasting and post-meal blood sugar levels. This is because they have slowly digestible starch in their grains. Starches are long chains of glucose that are often in grains, potatoes, and other foods. Starch is difficult for your body to digest. In fact, some parts of starch can't be digested at all. High starch foods may cause side effects such as constipation. So, what does starch mean for diabetics? Well, starch gets broken down by enzymes to produce glucose. This means that high starch foods may cause higher levels of blood sugar. Millet is a fantastic grain to add to your diet. It's a low glycemic index food and has slowly digestible starch. Our next food is another grass-grown grain, but this one's commonly used in bread loaves. Number 4, rye. Rye is a grain that's a member of the wheat family. It's often used in flour, bread, beer, whiskey, and vodka. When rye is in the form of foods like flour or bread, it's able to aid blood sugar control. This is because of several different qualities. First, it's high in soluble fiber, which is one of the two types of fiber. Soluble fiber dissolves in water and forms a gel-like consistency. It helps to slow the digestion and absorption of carbs and sugar, leading to slower rise in blood sugar levels. Rye bread also contains special phenolic compounds, such as ferulic acid and caffeic acid. These help to slow the release of blood sugar and insulin into your bloodstream. Ferulic acid also has some other amazing properties. It helps to enhance the capacity of antioxidants in your body. It does this by balancing out the levels of free radicals and antioxidants in your body. An imbalance of free radicals may cause oxidative stress, which we talked about earlier. Caffeic acid is also a fantastic compound to fight against diabetes. It is also able to enhance the antioxidants in your body, but more than this, it can enhance insulin secretion, which keeps your blood sugar levels under control. Try adding rye into your diet by using rye flour or rye bread as an alternative to white bread. Coming up, we've got a grain that, like rye, is high in fiber. But this next one is packed with a different type of fiber. Number 3, bulgur. Did you know that there are two different types of fiber? There are soluble fiber and insoluble fiber. We've already talked about soluble fiber and its benefits for diabetics, but what about insoluble fiber? Insoluble fiber adds bulk to your stool. This helps food pass more quickly through your stomach and intestines. While bulgur contains both soluble and insoluble fiber, it has around 90% insoluble fiber. But what is bulgur? Bulgur is an ancient grain that was popular in the ancient Mediterranean region. It is now a staple in Middle Eastern and Mediterranean regions and is rich in many different nutrients. The insoluble fiber in bulgur helps diabetics in many ways. It helps with digestion, gut health, and weight management. This is because eating fiber increases your feelings of fullness. So, why is weight management important for diabetics? Being overweight or obese increases the risk of developing diabetes. This is because being overweight affects the function of your pancreas, which is where insulin is made. Insulin is a hormone which regulates your blood sugar levels, so it's essential when it comes to blood sugar control. Being overweight also contributes to a condition called insulin resistance. This is a resistance to the hormone insulin, which causes an increase in blood sugar. Bulgur is a delicious grain that can be eaten in side dishes, soup, or with bread and olive oil as a dip. Up next, we have another ancient grain, which is very versatile and can be used in lots of different dishes. Number 2, farro. Farro is a grain with a nutty taste and a chewy texture. It has high protein and high fiber. Half a cup of cooked farro contains 4 grams of protein. Protein is great for helping to stabilize blood sugar levels. This is because it slows the body's absorption of carbs and sugars. Protein breaks down into glucose a lot slower than carbs, meaning it tends to raise your blood sugar levels a lot slower. Farro is also rich in vitamin E, which is fantastic for diabetics. Not only is it an antioxidant, but it also helps to fight against insulin resistance. Vitamin E helps to decrease fasting insulin, glucose levels, and oxidative stress. Also, it helps to decrease inflammation. According to Diabetes Care Journal, high levels of inflammation may result in increased blood sugar levels. Farro also contains high levels of vitamin A, which is an essential nutrient for your body to produce insulin. We've talked about how your pancreas is responsible for producing insulin, but let's delve into this a little bit deeper. The part of the pancreas which creates insulin is particular cells called beta cells. Beta cells have a high number of cell surface receptors for vitamin A. But what does this mean for insulin secretion? Well, a study done by Lund University Diabetes Center states that vitamin A may have a positive effect on these cells. This means that they may also have a positive effect on their production of insulin, meaning farro is a fantastic grain to help lower and control blood sugar levels. And now, it's time for our number one whole grain. Give it up for our top blood sugar controlling grain, number one, quinoa. Quinoa is a very nutritious flowering plant in the amaranth family. It's packed with fiber, protein, and many vitamins and minerals such as magnesium and folate. The high levels of fiber and protein in quinoa are fantastic for controlling blood sugar. Quinoa is also rich in manganese, which is fantastic for blood sugar levels. Did you know manganese is heavily concentrated in your pancreas? We've already talked a little bit about the pancreas and how that's where insulin is made, but how does manganese affect this? Well, it's involved in the production of insulin. Manganese helps to make sure insulin is secreted properly, and it helps to control blood sugar levels. As well as manganese, quinoa is packed with iron. In fact, 1 cup of cooked quinoa has 16% of your daily recommended iron intake. A deficiency in iron can cause lots of symptoms, like fatigue, weakness, headache, and dizziness. Not only that, but iron deficiency can also have negative effects on your blood sugar control. It can damage the balance of insulin in your bloodstream. This means that for diabetics, it's super important to have decent levels of iron. There's 3 different types of quinoa: white, red, and black. But no matter which one you choose, you want to make sure you rinse it before you cook it. Also, you can buy quinoa in the form of flakes or flour. You can use quinoa as a side for a meal like you would use rice, or you can eat it in porridges, salads, or even smoothies. Like our six other whole grains, quinoa is a fantastic food to add into your diet, and it has incredible effects for blood sugar control. So we hope you learned something from this video, and we hope you found it helpful. Before you go, make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our other awesome videos. But wait, we didn't forget. We'd love to offer you two free gifts. Step up your kitchen game with 10 incredible foods that reduce blood sugar. Also, find out what the big food companies are hiding from you with the scary truth about sugar. To get your hands on these free gifts, click the link in the description box below. So, what's your favorite whole grain that helps control blood sugar? Let's talk! If you have any questions left or any suggestions for us, let us know in the comments below. Until next time, thanks for watching. From all of us here at Diabetics Talk, we hope you have a happy and diabetes-fighting day.